Hi guys, in this tip I will explain to you how you can add Google custom search to your site created in Adobe Muse. Here is a live example of my site which is created in Adobe Muse, and here is demonstration of Google custom search. So I have magnifying glass icon in top navigation, and when someone clicks on that icon it will display Google custom search where user can perform type search term and to click on search button, and that will display search results in pop-up window, and search results will be limited to content from my site. There is also an close button or icon which users can use to collapse this search input field and button. And typically you will start with Google, just type Google custom search engine and then click on Google custom search engine link. That will open a page where you need first to first click on new search engine, then go to setup, and you will need to add description and give a search engine name, and you also have many other options like to specify which sites to be indexed and from which sites you want to display search results. Another thing you should do is to go to look and feel tab. And here you have customization options to customize your search box, search button, and other things. And then from layout, you can choose your layout and to test how your search engine will perform. There are options like two-page where you can display custom search input and button on one page and then search results on some other page. That's a little bit tricky, and I will stick with overlay layout for my demonstration. And after choosing layout, just click on save and get code, and then copy code and switch to Adobe Muse. In Adobe Muse, you will typically want to start with master page to save some time, because all components from master page will be automatically transferred and added to any other page that you have applied that master. So in Muse with master page active, go to object, insert HTML, and in edit HTML simply paste code from Google site, and Muse will render preview of Google custom search input and button. You can expand it just to ensure that people can type few words here, and for someone that's enough. You can position your custom search anywhere that you want to appear on your pages. For those who want to save space, and that's important if you are creating responsive layouts, I will explain to you how to recreate this layout with magnifying glass or some other icon which will indicate to user where to click and to expand search box and to perform search. So you will need additional components. That's one icon which I have created in Adobe Photoshop, and it is exported as PNG with transparent background. And another component is from widgets library, then expand compositions, and then drag blank composition on your page. And let me explain you for a moment how this composition works. So there are triggers, and when someone clicks on trigger, that will display target. I will move this trigger on side, and I want to remove two other triggers and targets which I don't want to use. And another thing you should do is to click on this blue triangle on side and ensure that you have show target on click, then check hide all initially, and that will hide this target when page loads. And typically you want to include a close button to allow users to collapse this target field. I will remove fill and stroke from this target field, although you may decide to use a color which is same as your background color on your site. I will simply remove it to have transparent background, and I want to ensure that for other states I don't have fill and stroke. And next step is to move this rendered preview inside this target field. So when you move element inside target, that will display bold stroke around the target field, and that will indicate that you are positioning your element inside this field. So let me just shrink this target field to match this rendered preview, and I will position that close to trigger and this close button, and then let's go to preview mode to preview changes or to see what I already have done. So here is trigger, and when someone clicks, that will display Google custom search input field and search button. And here is close, so everything works as expected. Now I will want to reposition this trigger, and I want to remove fill and stroke. So I will remove, select trigger, and then simply remove fill and stroke, and ensure that you have removed for all states fill and stroke if you want completely transparent trigger. So let me go to rollover, remove stroke, mouse down, and active, so it's completely transparent. And this bounding box is defining area where users can click and to expand this Google custom search. So the last thing is to import some icon or indicator for user where to click, and I will copy and paste this existing one, and I will move it inside trigger. So let's test how everything works. We go to preview tab, and here is my magnifying glass, and when user navigate mouse over it and click, that will display Google custom search input and button. So let's test it. I will type something and click on search, and it displays a preview in pop-up window, and this can be a small problem, so you need to think about this close button, which is visible, so it's suitable. If you want to position it at top, it may not be best solution to use overlay layout if you want to position your Google custom search somewhere on page. So everything works as expected. And the last thing is to position this composition where you want to appear on your page, on your pages. So that's how to implement Google custom search engine to your Muse site. If you want, if you need some additional explanation, or you have some question or doubt, please do not hesitate to leave comments on YouTube or my site, which is Design Easy.